Let's take a look at angular velocity and angular momentum as they relate to the right-hand rule. So, the first one is this ice skater is spinning around like so. And you take your right hand, if you want to determine the direction of the angular velocity vector, and conversely, similarly, that is, the direction of the angular momentum vector, you take your right hand and you curl your fingers around in the direction of rotation, because this person is rotating like this, and your thumb points in the direction of the angular velocity vector, which is the same direction as the angular momentum vector. Because if this is omega, well, L is just proportional to omega by this equation. You know, this number describes how this person's mass is distributed about some axis, right? And so this is just some scalar quantity, and so these two are in the same direction, so like so. Notice that if you look down from above, that the person would be rotating counterclockwise. And it's not a bad idea to bring, you know, a Coke bottle, or this is a Dr. Pepper bottle, in for the exam, and you look down from the top, right? You know, you can actually take it and do like this, and you look down from the top and you can rotate your fingers and you see, oh, okay, yeah, it's up, right? This is a good spatial, you know, trick to bring with you into the exam, okay? All right, now, you might say to yourself, well, these two vectors are pointing up, but nothing's actually moving up. What the heck is, what's going on with that? Well, this is just the way that we've decided to communicate with one another about spin. Because, think about it, how else are you going to draw it, right? Like, some people don't do so well at drawing, you know, three-dimensional circles that come out of the page, you know? And so, someone said, okay, let's just define, you know, something to be, you know, a convention that we can all agree upon, and someone came up with the right hand and said, okay, let me take my right hand, and if something, you know, the direction of my fingers curl around in the direction of that rotation, my thumb will point in the direction of the vector, and we'll all agree that that's true, and that way we can communicate with one another effectively. And that's it. That's all it is, okay? All right, let's take a look at the next one. This person is rotating this way, so you take your Coke bottle, and you look like this, right? And it's rotating like this, and you take your hands, or your right hand, always has to be your right hand, and you curl your fingers around the direction of rotation, and your thumb is pointing down, right? Or my thumb is pointing down, okay? Try it. You try it as we go. Okay, and so we know that those two, L is just proportional, right? L is equal to I omega. Okay? All right. Next example, we have this wheel, like this. It's spinning like so, right? Well, it's spinning like this. Let's try to draw it isometrically coming out of the board like this. We see the difficulty now, right? And so, if we're having trouble seeing it, we'll take our Coke bottle, and it's rotating like this, right? We curl our fingers around in the direction of rotation. Our thumb points to the right. And so the angular moment, the angular velocity vector is in this direction. And the angular momentum is in the same direction. Okay? And I is usually some number greater than 1. So the magnitude of L is usually, in terms of what the number is usually bigger than omega. Okay? All right. So let me take a real life example. Let's take this wheel here. Okay, we're gonna rotate it like this. Take our fingers, curl it around. The rim is moving in this direction. Point our fingers in the direction it's moving. See, our thumb points up, right? And in fact, the vector of concern is always perpendicular to the plane, right? The plane of rotation. So the angular velocity vector points, you know, in this direction of this spool here, right? Okay. And, of course, that's the direction, the same direction as the angular momentum, because L equals I omega. Okay. All right. And, oh, let's do another one. Let's do this one. Let's turn it back in the other direction. Curl our fingers in the direction of that, and our thumb points that way. And so that's the convention for the angular velocity whenever it's spinning that way. All right. Try it out. It comes up. You're going to see it on the exam. See you next time.